In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create this cute jellyfish animation. Hey guys, my name is Manuel. Let's dive right in. First of all, we create the body. Therefore, we use the polygon tool, double click on it to create a shape. Then let's name this dude Jellyfish. In the polystar path property, we set points to 3, outer radius to 250. Next, we right-click on the path and convert it to a bezier path. We use the convert vertex tool to round all 3 corners. In the first pose, Jellyfish is about to push down to gain speed. His shape is very wide and short, almost like a helmet or a lampshade. We move the bottom 2 points up, holding shift. Then we move them further apart, holding command and shift for Mac, control and shift if you use a PC. Let's move it a tiny bit further up. We need to change the color, use a gradient fill. I want Jellyfish to be pink, so I use purple as the darker color and pink as the brighter one. Let's adjust the start and end position to get a diagonal direction. Alright, we add a path keyframe at the beginning. Then let's create the second pose in 1 second and 12 frames. The shape now is narrow and stretched. Jellyfish has pushed down and is just about to go back to pose 1. We move the shape slightly up and the 2 bottom points down and closer together, but leave some space for the tentacles. The 2 corners are pointing outwards. At 2 seconds and 12 frames, which is half of our comp length, it is pose 1 again. We copy and paste the first keyframe. Then we copy these last 2 keyframes and paste them at 4 and 5 seconds. Well, I'd say not quite there yet. We select all keyframes and open the graph editor to adjust the speed graph. Let's first add easy ease, then let's adjust the curve. We mainly slow down the 2 middle parts. It almost looks like the letter M twice. Let's check it out. That looks good. Fast push, then slowing down. Then we use the effects and presets window to add a glow effect. Set the glow radius to 100, roughly. Next we add turbulent displace to give it a more wobbly shape. Displacement, turbulent smoother. We reduce the amount to 10, size 100, complexity 1. In evolution options, we activate cycle evolution. Set an evolution keyframe at the beginning, and at the end, at 120 frames, we set it to 1, with no degrees, which creates a seamless loop. Alright, let's take care of the background. We add a new solid, name it background, and move it to the bottom. And add a gradient ramp. Let's change the position of the start and end of ramp to get a diagonal direction. Colors, a very dark purple, almost black, and a dark blue. Then we add one more solid. This one will be animated. And add fractal noise. Beautiful. Contrast around 700. Brightness minus 50. Inference form, we scale it up to 3, maybe 200. Then, like before, we animate the evolution, activate cycle evolution to get a seamless loop. We set an evolution keyframe at the beginning, at 120 frames. That's the end, plus 1 frame, we set it to 1. Okay. Then we add directional blur. And set the blur length to around 600. Next, we use tritone to add some color. Let's change the colors. Highlights a bright pink, midtones a bright purple, shadows a very dark purple. And then we set the blending mode of the solid to lighten. And we probably should reduce the opacity of the solid. Let's check it out. Alright, the thing is, Jellyfish seems to be stuck. we need to have some objects that move downwards to let Jellyfish move upwards. How about we add some bubbles? They're easy to create. So let's use the ellipse tool to do that. Now fill. Stroke width 4 pixels. We spread them all around the screen in different sizes. Hold shift to create a circle. That's enough. Let's name the solid bubbles and let's maybe change the label color. So how do we turn that into a looping animation? We duplicate the layer and move the upper layer above the screen. That's Y minus 540 pixels. Then link the bottom layer to the upper one and animate its position from minus 540 pixels at the beginning to 540 pixels at 2 seconds and 12 frames. You adjust the endpoint of the two comps and open the graph editor to edit the speed curve. We slow down the end mostly and the beginning slightly. Let's see. Okay, the second half is still missing, but the timing seems right. We duplicate the two layers and move them to the right, to the second part. Awesome, now Jellyfish finally seems to move upwards. We should maybe reduce the opacity a little bit. What's still missing is the tentacles. Jellyfish needs some arms, right? So first of all, how do we attach them? By selecting the Jellyfish body path, grabbing the pen tool and adding a point for every tentacle you want to add. Let's add 3 points here along the bottom edge. That'll be 5 tentacles overall. Then with the path selected, we go to Window and select the Create Nulls from Path script. We choose Nulls Follow Points. So we have 5 null objects along the bottom edge, to which we can each link a tentacle. To the top one, we could link a face, for example. You might have seen the null positions jump. The positions at the end are different from the positions at the beginning. To solve this, we copy the first keyframe and paste it to the end. Let's see. Awesome. And since we are at it, let's paste it to the middle keyframe as well. And let's spread the points more equally here at the second and fourth keyframe as well. We copy this keyframe and paste it to 4 seconds. With no layer selected, we grab the pen tool. Set the stroke width to around 25 pixels and draw the first tentacle. Let's name it Tentacle 1. Move it below the body in the layer stacking order. Then we open the contents property, go into the shape property, stroke property, and in taper, we set the end length to 100%. Then let's move to the beginning and position the path next to the left corner. Set a path keyframe, link it to the most left null object. We animate the path some more. At 12 frames, we curve it upwards. At 46 frames, it's a vertical line again. At 2 seconds and 12 frames, we copy and paste the first keyframe. We select all of them and copy and paste them again. Then we copy the two effects from our Jellyfish body and paste them to the first tentacle. We reduce the glow radius to 60, and in turbulent displays we increase the amount to 30. Next, we open the graph editor, select all keyframes, and first of all, add easy ease. Then we create like a dome here and here. Then slightly smooth the other movements. Awesome. We duplicate the tentacle shape and move the layer to the right. to where the next null object is, roughly. And link the layer to this next null object. Then you might want to adjust the path shape a little, so that each tentacle has different behavior. Just make sure the first and last keyframe are exactly the same. Additionally, you might want to change the random seed in the turbulent displace effect. Check out the free project file to see how I added the eyes and the reflection, and make sure to check out all the other links in the description. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell, because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, guys.